magical nobles.
There are new billets being posted every day, but not enough...
Clive! Oh, am I glad to see you?
Is something wrong?
It's Blackthorn. He ain't himself. And if I'm honest, he ain't been for a while. Look, normally it only takes a couple of drinks to perk him back up, but not this time. Something's getting him down. And whatever it is, he ain't telling. It's like he's lost his spark, you know? He's barely got enough fire in his belly to get the ump about stuff. But I'm thinking he might if we both bent his ear, because he respects you, innit? So, what'd you say?
Fine. If you think it will help.
I knew you'd understand.
But if he doesn't want to talk, we let him be. He'll open up when he's ready.
All right. Now, he'll only smell a rat if we both turn up at once. So, I'll go first, and you can meet us at the forge. Wait a bit, then head over when you're ready.
She's taken quite a liking to Lady Cat.
First August, and now you. What are you pair up to? What's it got to do with me?
August was worried that something had been weighing on your mind. I thought you might want to talk about it.
Did you now? I told you not to stick your nose in my business. What'd you go and do?
Clive just wants to help, innit? What's so bad about that? Talk to him. You never know, you might feel better for getting it all out in the open. Please, mate. I'm worried about you.
Phil shut you up. It's nothing really. Stupid. Not the sort of thing you'd bother people about.
Why don't you tell us all the same?
Karen and I have an arrangement. I keep an eye on Goots, and she shows me what the competition's up to. Interesting arms and armor, things like that. Anyway, the other day, she shows me a cuirass she's come by. Masterpiece of level work. Light, supple, and tougher than it had any right to be. Made my stuff look like every clumsy shit. I should have brought the bastard thing there and then just to study it, but I was too proud. And now every time I reach for my hammer, I'm reminded that I'm not the craftsman I thought I was. There. You happy? You got what you came for. Now piss off.
All right. We're going. I always thought of old Blackthorn as a bit of a force of nature. Like a storm cloud full of ale. Didn't think anything could rattle him. Least of all a stupid piece of leather.
Blackthorn's always taken pride in his craft. Questioning it means questioning himself. Something tells me this is only going to get worse. If he has doubts, it will affect his work, which will only add to his problems. We need to nip this in the bud.
I couldn't agree more.
He said he should have bought that cuirass. Perhaps we should track it down for him. Assuming you're happy to help, that is.
Too bloody right I am.
Glad to hear it. First things first, then. We need to speak to Karen.
So, we find a cuirass, give it to Blackthorn, then he works out how to make it and goes back to being his surly old self, right? Simple.
Karen, do you have a moment? Blackthorn mentioned that you'd recently come by a leather cuirass. An exquisite example of the craft, from what he told us.
And he ain't been himself since he saw it. So we thought we'd buy it for him.
Sorry, sold it already. Didn't think Blackthorn cared for it the way he turned his nose up. But it were nicely put together, that's for certain. Even if the bloke who made it is a bit of an odd one. Happened across him on my travels. Makes all his stuff to order, but the fella who commissioned it refused to pay. He didn't like the colour of summer. So I took it off his hands for a fair price.
You don't know where we might find him, do you?
Like I said, he's a bit of an odd one. Doesn't even have a workshop. He doesn't trust hunters neither, which means he spends as much time out tracking beasties as he does working their hides.
I see.
He did tell me something, though. Apparently, his next commission's for a set of griffin hide greaves.
Here, there's a griffin on the hunt board. The curse breakers were placing bets on who'd bag it. Now, where the bleeding hell was excited? Somewhere in Sambrec, maybe. Cairnorvan, that was it.
Thank you, Karen. We'd be lost without you.
At least you admit it.
So, it sounds like going after that griffin might be the best chance we have of finding our roaming leather worker.
I'll leave the hunting to you, if you don't mind. While you get on with that, I'll ask around the markets. See if I can't sniff out who he is and where he's hiding.
Good idea. Hopefully one of us will be able to track him down.
company.
Safe.
There is no coin to be had in this miserable land. Even if they wanted to trade with us.
I know. It was hard for us Dalmecs here in Sandbrek before the capital fell, but now we'd be stoned if we even approached Northreach.
Come on. Faster! Let's go. Faster. Come on. Fly, Ambrosia. Be safe.
You deserve a rest. This isn't going to be easy. Well, I know I will. Ready, go? This won't be easy. Be safe. Good girl. Time to fight. Thanks, girl. Griffins don't exactly make for easy prey. Let's hope our craftsman hasn't bitten off more than he can chew.
Good day to you.
It's all but spent. The crystal.
You're quite talented with that rod of yours.
Ready, go.
Yeah.
Time to fight. Something there, boy. Could that be our man? Are you all right?
Yeah. Dare say I'll survive. That griffin caught me before I could get an arrow off. Must have lost sight of me in the grass, though. I'd be dead if it hadn't.
More likely than not.
The name's Camille. I'm a lowly leather worker, if you couldn't tell by the smell of me.
Not so lowly from what I hear. Do you remember selling to a merchant by the name of Karen?
She's not an easy woman to forget. Bought a cuirass from me after I lost my buyer. Quite taken with my work, as far as I recall. Didn't stop her bartering me down to a pittance, though. She sent you for a refund.
It's not her who sent me.
Well, consider me flattered.
You should be. He's a master of his art, and not an easy man to impress.
Blacksmiths are proud folk. It's a rare thing indeed for one to praise a glorified tanner. And I don't imagine an impressive swordsman like yourself would be getting your steel from any but the best. I'd dearly love to help a fellow craftsman, but... Well, actually, I suppose you could give him this.
What is it?
Treated leather. Same stuff I used to make that cuirass. If your man's as skilled as he sounds, he'll know what he's looking at.
You sure?
Well, you did save my life. And thanks to you, I'll be going home with all the griffin hide I can carry. I'd say it's the least I can do. Short of showing him how to make the thing myself, that is. But there are rules against it. Secrets of the trade and whatnot.
In that case, I'll see that he gets it.
I'd be much obliged if you would. Right, I've got some greaves to make. You send your blacksmith my regards.
Will do. And thank you. Hopefully this will sweeten Blackthorn's mood.